Hello all, our project title is SCADA for Remote Industrial Plant Operation, submitted by Dinesh Venkatesh Ruthwik under guidance of G. Swapna. Coming to our project, the project aims in designing a system which is capable of detecting temperatures using LM35 sensors and controlling the relay system. The temperature sensor senses the temperature and the potentiometers are used to set the temperature. If the limit violates, then it trips the relay switches. So, coming to our components, we have a 230 volts AC supply connected to a transformer. This is a step down transformer which converts 230 AC to 12 AC. So, the step down transformer is then connected to a bridge rectifier. This converts 12 volts AC to 12 volts DC, which is not pure DC, so that we are connecting a filter. Here a capacitor is connected in a parallel path. As we all know that capacitor allows AC and blocks DC. So parallel connected capacitor allows AC and which is grounded. So a pure 12 volts DC comes to the input side of voltage regulator. Voltage regulator is used to provide a constant voltage. If the input varies, the output of voltage regulator does not vary. So we are using a 7805 series voltage regulator so that we get a 5 volts of constant DC output from the voltage regulator, which is connected to the PIC microcontroller here. Then there are a few LEDs which are used for indication purpose, and these are the temperature sensors 1 and 2 for relays 1 and 2, and these are two potentiometers used for setting temperature, set temperature 1 and set temperature 2, and this is a crystal oscillator. These are the connections to PC and to relay from the microcontroller. While coming to the interface connections from microcontroller, we are connecting a USB TTL here. The USB TTL acts as an interface between microcontroller and our PC. These are the two indicator bulbs. We can also use them as our loads. The relay circuit has a relay and a transistor and LEDs for indication purpose and a diode. So, coming to our block diagram, a regulated power supply is connected to a microcontroller, and then the microcontroller has the input voltage. The analog inputs from the temperature sensors are taken by the microcontroller. Potentiometer sets the threshold value of the temperature. Reset button is used to reset the microcontroller at any instant of operation. Crystal oscillator provides additional frequency so that it fasten our instruction per cycle, and the LED indicators for indication purpose, relay drivers which are used for controlling and alerts us when the limit violates, and USB to TTL interface to connect to a PC. So the reason we are using PIC microcontroller here instead of 8051 microcontroller that 8051 microcontroller need to be taken out from the kit and installed in a kit which is then connected to a system to dump its software. But by using PIC microcontroller, we can directly dump the program by using these ICSP program protocol. ICSP stands for in circuit serial program. So by using this function, we can easily dump program by several times. Then there is another advantage of processing function, because 8051 microcontroller has a function has an instruction cycle for about 1 microsecond, but by using PIC microcontroller we can achieve the same instruction in 100 nanoseconds. Then coming to our project. Okay, let us switch on our project. As the program is already dumped, the bulb glows. So, as you all can see, these two bulbs are indication of that temperature sensors here are not violating our threshold limit set by these two potentiometers. So to observe these results, as the name SCADA gives that, to observe these results, we are using a hyperterminal software. So give it a name, SCADA. Here we are using a special software which is USB to TTL software to get that COM port, and restore to default. Yeah. So the temperature 1 and temperature 2 are the temperature sensors values, and these are the set temperature values, which are 40 degrees for one potentiometer and 50 degrees for other. So this is the step by step, and let us see what happens when we change the temperature of temperature sensor 1, set temperature of temperature sensor. Yeah, it reaches to 39 degrees. What happens when the temperature sensor 1 goes beyond 39 degrees? I am putting a solder here, solder rod. Okay. See, first bulb going off. So by observing this, we can conclude that whenever the temperature sensor value is greater than the set temperature, then our relay trips. Or the project can be extended using GPRS modem, through which alternating and monitoring data about sensors can be viewed on the website, and we can also connect a gas leakage sensor or a PIR sensor or IR sensor instead of temperature sensor. So this is our project. Thank you.